there's a difference between mentorship and coaching, right? And I can get to that if we want, but to make a long story short.
Well, I mean, tell us how what was your experience with him mentoring you?
Yeah. So the one thing, shared experiences is someone just giving you their experience of how it looks. You know, if you want a coach is going to tell you what to do. If you're an entrepreneur, you don't want to be told what to do. But you can always lean light. You can always figure out specifics about a person, about how to implement what you need based off of someone else's story, right? And they can always give you perspective. And that's really what you look for. In amongst of other things. But then he said, hey, listen, I've wanted to start a platform that gives startup entrepreneurs and seasoned entrepreneurs the opportunity to connect with business leaders they normally would not have access to. Mm. And that's how True Mentor started 5 years ago. And now,
so he pitched the idea to you.
Yeah. Well,
and you're like, this sounds kind of cool.
And he bought me out of my job. And,
oh, for real?
That's what I've been doing 5 years. Yeah.
Absolutely. Oh, for real?
Yeah. So he did that in 2014. Cool. So it's been an amazing run. You know, a lot of amazing people, and we have a philosophy as far as mentorship, and it's been going extremely well.
All right, so wait. First of all, how does he mentor you, which makes it not coaching? Is it really sharing a story, and then from that story, you glean a whole bunch of stuff that's hard to really communicate?
So there's a lot of things about mentorship. I could probably speak on it for like three, four days, but the whole embodiment of it. Think about what a coach does. What is a coach? Did you play any sports?
Football. I can picture my Coach Rodriguez right now yelling at me, grabbing my helmet, spitting in my face, all that other stuff.
He's making you great at the specific job that you're supposed to do.
That's right.
Right?
Tight end, baby.
And at the same time, too, he's doing all of that for you to execute in whatever he needs you to do. Right? That's not a mentor. A mentor is actually giving you the perspective, shared experiences. That's one way of doing it, but more so of accountability, a partner, if you will, in order for you to get to whatever you want to do, not whatever he needs you to do. Right? So, that's where the big difference is. Now you have like life coaches, right? Life coaches are there to coach you in whatever you say you're trying to accomplish. So they're going to give you tasks for you to go ahead and implement for the things that you say you want, but you have to do that. A mentor is giving you perspective, shared experiences, wisdom, right? And that's a big difference. You know what I mean? So, you know, a coach is a coach and you need it. Yes. But a mentor is a mentor and that's something different. Most things, the issue with a lot of people is a lot of people don't know the difference.
Well, and that you bring something up, and I think you might have said it around accountability of mentors. Like, you know, we have a lot of people have mentors, people they look up to, whether it's their demeanor in a conference room, whether, you know, how they speak to clients, how they're talking to their peers and to folks that work for them. And you take a lot away from that. A lot of times mentors don't know they're their mentors mentoring this person until, hey, did you know you've really been a mentor to me? And they're like, oh, well, then I think they become accountable once they know that because they feel like, oh, they've been actually looking up to me. You know,
who becomes accountable? The mentor becomes accountable to the mentee?
I think once they know that, I mean, there are leaders that know that people are looking at them and their experience. But their demeanor and who they are.
Well, they realize they have responsibility. But, you know, when, in a mentorship, as you know, to be frank with you, they're both accountable to each other. But the aggressor is always the mentee. It's not the mentor.
Right. It's got to be. That's what I was thinking. Like, I heard you say accountability from the mentor to the mentee. But I'm thinking, if the mentee doesn't rattle the cage of the mentor, the mentor's probably not going to pay too much attention. They're not gonna go out their way to be like, let me go mentor Dan Baker or Amr. You know, like, I don't.
Well, you got to understand the importance of, like, what does a mentor have that you don't? A mentor probably has a network that you like. A lot of the mentor CEOs that I know is because of Gary. You know what I mean? A lot of the things that you don't have, you get because a mentor gives it to you. Whereas a mentee, what does a mentee give a mentor? They give them life. They give them a newfound way of looking at things. They give them a different perspective as well. Sometimes the mentee becomes... The mentee is the mentor when it comes to newfound youth and way things are structured, right?
That's true.
So it's a hope, but again, it's not you telling someone what to do. I mean, that's the whole founding part of it. And like you said, yeah, some people don't even know that they're mentors. It's because you idolize them, you know, and it's a great thing. And sometimes, but those are those people, like, I don't know, LeBron is probably a mentor to others because of the way he's carried himself from 18 years old to even now. Mm. But also he knows that because there's people who look at him, he has to present himself in a specific way because there's a quality image about themselves about that. So So we can get down to reads.
Okay, so Dan's at this crossroads, right?
Right.
Even I'm looking at myself now, man. As you talk more, I'm like, shared perspectives. Damn, I could use some of that wisdom. let me get some wisdom. Right. Network, yeah, I'd love a bigger network. I mean, I work hard on my network, but that doesn't mean it has to stop.
Right.
I think I'm always looking for new people to network with.
Yeah.
So like, all right, so me or Dan. So here I am in a weird place in my life, trying to carve out some sort of livelihood in entertainment. I do a lot of stage stuff.
Yeah.
I do the podcast.
Right.
I do improv. Yeah. I do, I own this restaurant now. It's congrats. Kind of the entertainment business, yeah. You know? What was that?
Say congrats.
Thank you. Yeah. Yeah. It's a big congratulations. Fucking, it's kicking my ass.
That's good.
So like, I'm like, is there a mentor for all that shit? Impossible. It doesn't even cross my mind. Dan, I feel like it's like, and I'm probably wrong about that, by the way. Dan, I feel like, though, here you are. It feels a little bit more, people have been in his shoes before, you know? And so it might be find a mentor, benefit from that. So for me or for Dan, like let's start with Dan. So, like, would he benefit from having a mentor or true mentors or yeah, especially, like, the organization? Because like, it's weird. Yeah. It sounds like you guys are, like, formalizing mentee and mentorship.
Yeah. So True Mentors is the target market for True Mentors is startup entrepreneurs and seasoned entrepreneurs. So unless you have a business, and that's then it'd be like, you know, for Dan, theoretically, where he's at. But to be transparent.
I'm opening a restaurant. It's next door.
As long as it's an LLC and it's in business and it's moving, then we can talk, right?
Yeah.
But a mentor is in all stages, though. You know, like, you know, he's 34, right? But
yeah.
But at the same time, too, I guarantee you there's people who have been in his shoes that are also further along, you know. But the one thing I always try to stress to people is, you know, isolation gives decimation. You know what I mean? Like, when you isolate yourself, because a lot of people do that. Like, well, I'm trying to figure it out on my own. So you need a support system. And a support system is really what helps you out in so many things. And people forget that a support system is in all things. If you look at it was funny, one person was coming at me one time. I was like, man, you rely so much on your mentors. You rely so much on just the people you know. You rely so much on your network. And I was looking at them, I was like, okay, so, and you're trying to make fun of that, but if I was in a wheelchair, would you make fun of a person in a wheelchair? And he was like, well, not absolutely. Doesn't he rely so much on the wheelchair to get where he needs to go? Like, if I had a crutch, right? If I had crutches because I broke my foot, would you make fun of me because I'm on a crutch? He was like, no. Well, they're my crutch. They're my wheelchair. And it's okay to have that. And it's just, and I think a lot of people
It doesn't
feel,
make you weak.
No, it makes you stronger.
I think that's right.
You know what I mean? It makes you smarter, actually. The dumbest person is the person who thinks he knows everything.
Isolation is decimation.
Yeah.
Haters, gators are haters. Innovation is differentiation.
Yeah,
you bring it today, Quinn.
Yeah, so
I can't wait to hear the next one.
So anyway, you know, but now as for you, there's definitely opportunity for you because you have a business.
Yeah, but you heard this wacky shit I'm doing, right? I'm trying to bring it all together. I don't know what I'm doing. I literally have no idea what I'm doing.
That's where you should start. You gotta, you know, how do you eat an elephant? One bite at a time, right?
Quentin is a 5-month-old, so congratulations.
Yeah,
so
thank you.
Congrats, man.
And one day, he's going to have grandchildren or great-grandchildren that are like, you know, granddad always said, and there's going to be these sayings and multitudes of them. My son and my grandchildren are going to be like, Dad said, get off the couch. Because I have none of those.